Welcome in pediatric lecture series. Today is lecture 7, that is related with a very important topic in the pediatrics, is the childhood immunization. Immunization is backbone of the pediatrics in every child's career. It is a very important milestone. Myself, Dr. Sunil Nathamaske, working as a professor and dean in Dr. Vithura Vikhe Patil Foundation's Medical College and Hospital, Ahmednagar in Maharashtra. Now, these are the pioneering features who has done the work in the field of vaccination or immunization. Edward Jenner was born on 17th of May 1749 and died on 26th of January 1823. He is recognized as father of vaccination. He was an English physician and scientist who pioneered the concept of vaccines, and including creating the smallpox vaccine, which was the first vaccine in the era of the vaccination. It was the world's first vaccine. Next is the father of modern vaccine, John Franklin Enders, who is American biomedical scientist, is recognized as father of modern vaccines. Now, introduction. Vaccination and immunization have a similar meaning in everyday language. There are three terminologies which are used in vaccination. The first one is the inoculation, which means use of unweakened live pathogens. Second is the vaccination. It is the administration of vaccine to help the immune system to develop protection from a disease. And immunization means stimulating immune response with an infectious agent. Near about they are used for similar purpose, but these are the slight differences in the inoculation, vaccination, and immunization. The history of immunization started in 1798, just I told, with Edward Jenner, who pioneered the world's first vaccine with the smallpox. Later on, in 1886, typhoid vaccine was developed. In 1897, the plague vaccine was developed. Later on, in 1924, tetanus toxoid was developed. Then in 1927, tuberculosis, Mycobacterium bacteria, tuberculosis was discovered. Then in 1936, influenza. Before that, yellow fever, pertussis, diphtheria, bacillus were invented. And this is the timeline of this vaccination. Vaccination is one of the most effective and cost-effective way of protecting the children from lives and futures. Immunization is a key to child survival. Missing routine immunization can be life-threatening. And immunization is one of the most effective and cost-effective to protect the children's lives and futures. Immunization acts as a protective shield, keeping families and communities safe. Immunization is the process whereby a person is made immune or resistant to infectious disease, typically by the administration of a vaccine. Vaccines stimulate the body's own immune system to protect the person against subsequent infection or disease. Immunization is a proven tool for controlling and eliminating life-threatening infectious diseases. And vaccination does not require any major lifestyle changes. Immunization program is one of the key interventions for the protection of children from threatening conditions which are preventable. It is one of the largest program in the world concerned with the major public health intervention in the country. Now, immunization in India. Immunization program in India was introduced in 1978 as expanded program of immunization. The program gained momentum in 1985 and was expanded in as universal immunization program known as UIP to be implemented in a phased manner to cover all districts in 1989-90. Universal immunization program became a part of child survival and safe motherhood in 1992 program. In 1997, immunization became a component of National Reproductive and Child Health Program, NRCH program, and since last 2005. Types of immunization. First is the primary immunization. This is given right at the time of birth and goes on in first few years of life, building immune system of the particular diseases. This doses may be 1 to 5. Booster, these are given to enhance the efficiency of primary immunization, and at times goes by the level of antibodies start reducing. So by booster immunization, this level will be maintained and child will be protected from the disease. Mass immunization. This is done in order to eradicate the certain diseases completely. And till now we have success in the smallpox eradication. And next is in the queue is the pulse polio immunization. Two artificial methods of immunity. First one is the active immunization. Second one is the passive immunization. In active immunization, administration of antigen is given to the patient to protect the immune response. It is done by two ways, live vaccine or killed vaccine. Live vaccine is known as attenuated vaccine. It uses the pathogens with reduced virulence. It gives rise to the contact immunity. Second, inactivated or killed vaccine is safer than live vaccine. In this, microbes don't provide any antigenic molecule to stimulate the immune response, but often contains adjuvant chemical added to increase the effectivity of the antigens. Passive immunization. Individuals acquire immunity through the transfer of antibodies formed by immune individual or animal. Now, national immunization schedule. First immunization in national immunization schedule is the BCG, which is given at birth or as early as possible. Dose in infant is 0.1 ml, whereas below 1 month of age, that is in neonatal period, is 0.05 ml, given intradermally on the left upper arm. Hepatitis B bird dose given at birth or as early as possible within 24 hours. Dose is 0.5 ml intramuscular on anterolateral side of mid thigh on the left side. OPV at birth given as early as possible within 15 days, 2 drops orally. Again, OPV is repeated first, second and third at 6 weeks, 10 weeks and 14 weeks of life by giving 2 drops orally. Nowadays, IPV inactivated polio vaccine is also used at the age of 14 weeks, 0.5 ml intramuscularly on the anterolateral right side of the thigh. Pentavalent first, second and third doses given at 6 weeks, 10 weeks and 14 weeks of the age, 0.5 ml intramuscularly on the left anterolateral side of the thigh. Rotavirus vaccine is given at the age of 6 weeks, 10 weeks and 14 weeks, 5 drops orally. Measles first dose is given by 9 completed months to 12 months, also give up to 5 years if not received at the age of 9 to 12 months, 0.5 ml subcutaneous in right upper arm. Vitamin A first dose is given at the age of 9 months along with measles, 1 ml, that is 1 lakh international unit, orally. DPT first booster is given at the age of 16 to 24 months, 0.5 ml intramuscularly on the anterolateral side of the left thigh. OPV booster given at the same age, DPT 16 to 24 months, 2 drops orally. Measles second dose is given at the age of 16 to 24 months, 0.5 ml subcutaneous on the right upper arm. Vitamin A second dose to 9 dose are given 16 months with DPT and OPV booster. Then one dose every 6 months up to the age of 5 years is given 2 ml, that is 2 lakh international units, orally. DPT second booster is given at the age of 5 to 6 years as a 0.5 ml intramuscularly in the left upper arm or left thigh. Tetanus toxoid is given at the age of 10 years and 16 years, 0.5 ml intramuscular in the upper arm. Now for pregnant woman, T small d, first dose is given in early pregnancy, 0.5 ml intramuscularly in the upper arm, and T small d, second dose, 4 weeks after first dose, 0.5 ml intramuscular in the upper arm is given. And booster is given if received 2 doses in a pregnancy within last 3 years, 0.5 ml intramuscularly in the upper arm. There is a slight variation in the Indian Academy of Pediatrics recommendation. At birth, IAP has advised BCG, OPV 0 and hepatitis B 1. 6 weeks, IPV 1, DT small WP 1, hepatitis B 2, HIV vaccine 1, rotavirus and PCV, pneumococcal vaccine. 10 weeks, DTWP2, IPV 2, hepatitis B 2, rotavirus second, pneumococcal vaccine second. 14 weeks, DTWP third, IPV third, H influenza third, rotavirus third dose, pneumococcal vaccine third dose. At the age of 6 months, OPV1 and hepatitis B3. 9 months, OPV2 and MMR vaccine 1. 9 to 12 months, typhoid conjugated vaccine is advocated. 12 months, hepatitis A first dose is advocated. 15 months, MMR second dose, varicella first dose, pneumococcal vaccine booster dose. At 16 to 18 months, DTWP booster 1 or DTaP booster 1 is given. IPV booster first and H influenza B booster 1 is given. 18 months hepatitis A second dose, 2 years of age booster of typhoid conjugate vaccine is given. 4 to 6 years DTWP booster second or DTaP booster second, OPV third dose, MMR third dose and varicella vaccine second dose. At the age of 10 to 12 years, Tdap or TD vaccine is given, and for females, 3 doses of HPV is given, human papillomavirus vaccine, at the age of 0, 1 to 2 months and 6 months of the dose, these 3 doses are given. Now IAP has recommended adolescents as a separate vaccination schedule. Tdap or T small d is given at the age of 10 years, followed by every 10 years next dose. And when an adolescent is immunized earlier within 3 doses below 1 year, then booster dose at the age of 1.5 years and 5 years. MMR first dose is given at the age of 12 to 13 years, if not received earlier. Rubella in the girls, one dose is given at the age of 12 to 13 years, if MMR or rubella is not given earlier. Hepatitis B, 3 doses are given at the schedule of 0, 1 and 6 months, if not received earlier. Hepatitis 2 doses, 0 and 6 month duration is given. Typhoid, single dose intramuscularly, VI polysaccharide or 3 doses of oral typhoid vaccine on alternate day empty stomach is given, and booster is given at the age of, at every 3 years age. Varicella, that is a chickenpox vaccine, 1 dose up to 2 to 12 years of age and 2 doses after 12 years of age. HPV, only for girls at the age of 10 to 12 years with 3 doses schedule, 0, 1, 2 or second dose schedule is 0, 1, 6 depending upon the vaccination use. This was the immunization schedule. Now very important is the cold chain. Cold chain means the journey of vaccine from manufacturer to the beneficiaries, and it has 3 components. First, equipment used for vaccine transport and storage. Second, well-trained personnel involved in that, and third one is the efficient management procedure. Below in picture has shown vaccine manufacturer by air transport at 2 to 6 degrees centigrade or minus 15 to minus 25 degrees centigrade through aeroplane, then to goes to primary storage, then refrigerator van to the customer. This is the cold chain. In short, vaccine manufacturer, primary vaccine store, health center, immunization venue and patient, it goes to the transit storage, cold rooms, refrigerator and cold boxes. Certain vaccines are heat sensitive like OPV, measles, BCG, MMR, hepatitis B and DT. Certain vaccines are cold sensitive like hepatitis B, influenza, BCG. That's why where to store these vaccines are very important, and what temperature it is stored. Commonly two things are used for long storage temperature of the vaccine. First one is a routine refrigerator which we are using in the home, and second one is the ILR, ice line refrigerator, also known as deep freezer. If you keep the vaccine in the freezing compartment of the refrigerator, you have to keep the OPV, and in main compartment there are 3 compartments. In the main top one you keep the BCG, measles, MMR and mumps. In middle compartment, keep the DPT, small DT, TT, hepatitis A and B. In lower compartment, diluents are kept. Remember that in the doors, nothing is kept. Only you can keep the water bottles that is used for maintaining the temperature of the compartment when the electricity failure is there. To monitor these vaccines are effective or not, there are 3 vaccine vial monitors. First one is known as VVM. is a label that changes color when the vaccine vial or ampoule has been exposed to temperature above 8 degrees centigrade over a period of time. It is a printed on the label or a cap or neck of the ampoule, looks like a square inside a circle. As the vaccine vial is exposed to more heat, square becomes a darker. In normal condition, outer circle is darker and square is thin. But in defective vaccine, inside square becomes a dark. Do not use the vaccine that have reached this discard point, even if there is expiry is not assured. We should only vaccine use when the inner square in the VVM is lighter in color than the outside. Vials with VVM in which the inner square has begun to darken but is still lighter than the outside circle, it is used in the first priority. Vials with VVM in which inner circle matches the color of the outer square, in which inner square is darker than the outer circle, have reached or gone beyond discard point, this vaccine should not be used. It is given in short in this figure. Inner circle is faint, outer circle is dark, use that vaccine. And if the inner circle is dark, inner square is dark, then the outer circle, throw the vaccine. VVM respond to heat, but not to freezing. They do not measure exposure to freezing temperature. A vaccine may have been frozen, have lost its potency, but VVM cannot tell. That's why VVM is only temperature sensitive. It is not freezing sensitive. Freeze indicators. Devices used to monitor the exposure of vaccine to freezing. Freeze indicators are packed with batches of freeze sensitive vaccines, especially pentavalent, PCV and TT. The most common use type freeze indicator is a freeze tag. This is an irreversible temperature indicator that shows if a product such as vaccine has been exposed to freezing. It consists of electronic temperature measuring circuit with a liquid crystal display, that is LCD. Small blinking dot of light in the corner of display shows that freeze tag is functioning properly or not. This is shown in this yellow figure. If the freeze tag is exposed to a temperature below 0 degrees centigrade for more than 60 minutes, the display will change from good status to the alarm status. Vaccines that have been exposed to freezing may have been damaged and should be checked by using the shake test as described below. Now the shake test is the third parameter to check the vaccine. In this shake test, whether freeze sensitive vaccines like pentavalent, pneumococcal, TT or hepatitis have been subjected to freezing temperature which are likely to have damaged them. These are various steps like prepare a frozen control vial, then choose a test vial, then shake the control and test vial for 15 seconds, allow the vial to rest, then fifth stage, compare the vial for 30 minutes. These are the three parameters which test the vaccine potency. There are two terminologies which you will come across in this immunization: electronic vaccine intelligence network, small EVIN rollout. The government of India has rolled out an electronic vaccine intelligence network that digitizes the entire vaccine stock management, logistic and temperature tracking at all level of vaccine storage from manufacturing to sub-district, that is used in this cold chain process. This enables program managers to have real time of review of vaccine position, their store temperature across the cold chain procedure. EVIN has been completed in 12 stages in first phase. Now it is going on in 9 stages in second phase. And it is scaled to entire country. National Cold Chain Management Information System, NCC-MIS, tracks the cold chain equipment inventory, availability and functionality. So both these systems, EVIN and NCC-MIS, are part of cold chain management system. Mission Indradhanush was launched in December 2014 with aiming to increase the immunization coverage in the children up to 90%. Under this drive, focus is given on the low immunization pockets, and it was launched in 6 phases in 544 districts, and later on it was spread to all over. In these 2 phases of the Mission Indradhanush, immunization coverage was increased in the satisfactory level. Now we are going to see all the vaccine one by one. First one is the BCG vaccine, which is primarily used against the tuberculosis. This is a live attenuated vaccine of the bacillus Calmette and Guerin. These are the strains of Mycobacterium bovine and named as per these 2 scientists who invented this BCG. Albert Calmette is a French physician and bacteriologist, and Carmine Guerin was a veterinarian doctor. Both had done pioneering work on the BCG, and the first vaccine was used in 1921 at Pasteur Institute of Lille. Currently, five strains are there: Pasteur 1173P2, Danish 1331, Galaxo 1017, and Tokyo 172-1. It is come in dry powder. Medium in which it is used is TIC, BCG organism grown on the freeze-dried cake and having ingredients of glycerin, aspirin, citric acid, potassium phosphate, iron ammonium citrate. Final preparation is a freeze-drying, also contains lactose. Its dilution requires the sterile water for injection. No preservatives to be added, and see that its level of the VVM before that. Dose of BCG in the newborn is 0.05 ml, and after that it is 0.1 ml. Intradermally on the left upper side, it is given with the help of BCG syringe. Except in the neonatal age, you have to do the tuberculin skin test before giving or administering the BCG. A reactive tuberculin skin test is contraindication for BCG. BCG is protective 60-80%, and its duration of the protection is not known. But it is known that it is great in preventing miliary tuberculosis and tuberculous meningitis. There are rare side effects like redness, swelling, small ulcer, mild pain, supporotic lymphadenitis, non-supporotic lymphadenitis, also known as BCG OMA. If it is accidentally given in spite of intradermally, subcutaneously, then local abscess occurs. Commonly, BCG vaccine is used in the tuberculosis, leprosy, bullous ulcer infection, non-tuberculous mycobacterial infection, bladder cancer, type 1 diabetes, and today it is tried under the COVID-19. There are certain contraindications like HIV infection, immune deficiency, allergy, anaphylaxis, active tuberculosis, and there is a family history of immune deficiency. BCG is stored at the 2 to 8 degrees centigrade, and since it is live vaccine. Next is the OPV or oral polio vaccine. It was invented by John Salk with his team in 1952. OPV has three strains. It is known as Sabin strain 1, 2, and 3. It is live. It is attenuated virus particle of the OPV harvested on the monkey's kidney cell culture. Oral polio vaccine stimulates the immune system against the polio 3 strains, and this virus persists in the GI tract for 4 to 6 weeks, inducing both mucosal and serum antipolio virus antibodies. OPV also produces local immune response in the lining of the intestine. It is the primary site of poliovirus multiplication. Antibodies produced there inhibits multiplication of the subsequent wild virus. OPV is provided in the vial of the 10 to 20 doses. Single dose of OPV, 2 drops, contains 10 lakhs of the Sabin 1, 1 lakh of Sabin 2, and 6 lakh of Sabin 3 strain. Also, this vaccine contains the neomycin and streptomycin in small quantity, does not contain any preservative. This is given at bus immunization schedule, and it is given orally, 2 drops by mouth. Poliovirus antibodies are distributed into breast milk. It is not known whether it crosses placenta or not. There are very few side effects, comes rarely, like paralytic poliomyelitis, Guillain-Barré syndrome, anaphylactic shock, and fever, but its percentage is very, very rare. Steroids, antimetabolites, radiation therapy, this interacts with the OPV. Once open, the vaccine should be used within 2 hours of the storage. You have to monitor the vaccine while monitor color of the square and color of the circle. There is a campaign for the mass immunization, or is the pulse polio eradication, which is launched in the India to eradicate the vaccine. Now the IPV, it was invented by Dr. John Salk, also known as Salk, in 1955. It consists of inactivated poliovirus strains of all three viruses. It is given intramuscularly or intradermally. It produces antibodies in the blood against three types of the poliovirus. IPV provides serum immunity, and it has very few side effects, and these are transient. Each dose is 0.5 ml. It is stored between 2 to 8 degrees centigrade, and shelf life is 24 to 36 months. It gives, after first dose, protection of the 19 to 46% for type 1, 32 to 63% on the type 2, 28% 54% against type 3 after first dose of immunization. Do not freeze this vaccine, discard if frozen, Safe test can be done for IPV if it is frozen. It has advantage that it is not a live vaccine. There is no risk of paralysis. It triggers excellent protective immune response in most of the people. It is safe vaccine and it is efficacious vaccine. Disadvantage is only that it requires expertise since it is given in the parenterally. And next vaccine is the DPT. It is a combination of three vaccines used against the three infectious diseases like diphtheria, pertussis, whooping cough, and tetanus. Tetanus and diphtheria and pertussis vaccination are licensed in 1949. There are two forms of DTP. One is DTAP and second is DTWP. A means acellular, W means whole cell vaccine. This describes the kind of organism used for making the vaccine. DTWP uses the whole cell pertussis bacteria to create the vaccine, whereas in DTAP uses only part of the cell. Difference in the composition of the vaccine leads to difference in reaction in the babies and children. DTAP is a combination of the vaccine against diphtheria, tetanus, and pertussis, where pertussis component is acellular. In contrast to DTWP, where whole cell or inactivated pertussis is used, the acellular vaccine uses selected antigens of the pertussis pathogens to induce the immunity. Side effects of the DTAP are soreness, fever, irritability, tiredness, loss of appetite, vomiting, seizures, lowered consciousness, and high fever up to 105 Fahrenheit. Whereas Tdap has a few side effects like pain and swelling at the site of injection, mild fever, headache, tiredness, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea. Dose of the both types is 0.5 ml intramuscularly. Three doses are given, 6 to 8 weeks of the duration. Second, 10 to 12 weeks of duration. Next is 14 to 24 weeks of duration. Two booster doses are advocated, 0.5 ml after 12 months, and second, 4 to 6 years of life. Each single 0.5 ml dose contains diphtheria toxide, more than 30 international units, tetanus toxide, more than 40 units, beta pertussis, more than 4 international units, adserts, aluminum phosphate, and preservatives, thymer salt. You have to store this vaccine at the temperature of 2 to 8 degrees centigrade. Next vaccine is measles vaccine. It is discovered by Maurice Hilleman, and more than 8 vaccines are developed by Maurice Hilleman. In 1960, this was discovered as a safe and effective inexpensive vaccine. WHO has recommended immunization of all susceptible children and adults for whom measles vaccination is not contraindicated. Two doses of measles are given alone or along with measles, mumps, and rubella. Also, it can be combined with varicella. It is live attenuated vaccine derived from Edmonton Jaguar strain. And WHO recommended two doses of this vaccine. First dose at the age of 9 months, second dose at the age of 15 to 18 months. One dose gives 93% of effectivity. Two doses gives 97% of the effectivity against the measles. It is given subcutaneously 0.5 ml on the thigh or right arm. 16th March is declared as Measles Immunization Day. Every yearly it is celebrated against the measles campaign. Measles has few adverse effects like fever, rash, injection at the site, febrile seizures, thrombocytopenia, encephalopathy, SSPI, subacute sclerosing panencephalitis. Sometimes it gives rise to Guillain-Barré syndrome or inflammatory bowel diseases. Remember that in pregnancy, tuberculosis, measles vaccine is contraindicated. Mumps vaccine. This vaccine prevents the mumps, developed by researcher Maurice Hilleman, and it is used separately or with the MMR vaccine along with the two doses. It is given by 12 months of age up to the 10 years of age, and second dose is advocated before the 6 years of age, and it is safe and effective vaccine for the mumps. Rubella vaccine. It prevents the rubella. RA27 strain is commonly used as a live attenuated rubella vaccine. It is reconstituted vaccine given subcutaneously 0.5 ml and there is no preservative in this. It can be given 6 years if the vaccine is not given. Two doses is given. Side effects are fever, mild rash, and swollen glands at the cheek or neck. It is stored at the 10 degrees centigrade. Now, very important vaccine is the rotavirus vaccine. This is used to protect against the rotavirus infection that leads to the diarrhea in children, and it prevents 45% death worldwide. WHO has recommended the first dose of vaccine to be given right after the 6 weeks of the age in each and every baby. 2 to 3 doses are given 1 month apart, and this is not recommended for use in children over the age of 2 years. That means from 6 weeks of the age up to the age of 2 years, this vaccine is given. There are various types are there depending on the dose schedule, and sequence also changes. Commonly used the Rotarix, which is given orally, alternative vaccine. Rotatec is there, Rotavac, Rotavin 1, M1, Lanzo, Lambon, and Rotacil. Now important vaccine given in the girls is the human papillomavirus vaccine, HPV, given commonly at the age of 11 to 12 years, 2 doses 6 to 12 months apart, and 0.5 ml given pre-filled syringe comes, and it protects against the following types of cancers in the girls: cervical cancer in females, vaginal and vulvar cancer in females, anal cancer both in male and female, throat cancer both in male and female, penile cancer in male, genital warts in both male and females. Now hepatitis B vaccine. This protects against hepatitis B disease. 0.5 ml at the age of 0-16 months intramuscularly given. It is stored at the temperature of 2 to 8 degrees centigrade. There are very few side effects. Hepatitis A vaccine protects against the hepatitis A disease. It is effective around 95% of the cases. Routinely given 2 doses 0.5 ml intramuscularly and 1 ml dose in adults 6 to 12 months apart, with side effects of soreness at the site of injection, headache, loss of appetite, and tiredness. H-influenza B. This protects against this H-influenza type B virus infection. Given 3 to 4 doses. First dose is given 2 months of age, and series is completed by 12 to 15 months of age. This is given intramuscularly, and booster is given 12 to 15 months of age. It is stored in the temperature of 2 to 8 degrees centigrade. Do not freeze the vaccine. Next vaccine is tetanus toxoid, which is very commonly, and since long back it is given to protect against the tetanus. 5 doses are recommended, with 6 given during the adolescence. Booster dose should be given within 48 hours of injury to people who are not immunized or whose immunization status is out of status. 3 doses are recommended initially. Route is intramuscular 0.5 ml. This vaccine is stored at the temperature of 2 to 8 degrees. This is very safe during pregnancy and HIV also. Very few side effects like fever, redness, swelling at the site of the injection. Now typhoid vaccine. It prevents the typhoid fever. There are 3 types. Typhoid conjugate vaccine, TY21A live vaccine, which is given by the mouth. Third one is the VI capsular polysaccharide vaccine. Typhoid vaccine has a few side effects like abdominal pain, headache, diarrhea. This vaccine is stored at the temperature of 2 to 8 degrees centigrade. These 3 types. In first one is the whole cell vaccine, killed S typhi, often with S paratyphi, developed by Wright in 1896. It is stored, given subcutaneously, 2 doses 4 weeks apart, and dose is 0.25 to 0.5 ml, primary given 0.5 ml, also booster. VI polysaccharide vaccine, developed by Robin in 1984. It is liquid, given intramuscularly at or 2 years of age, 0.5 ml, and booster at the age of 3 years. Oral vaccine is of live attenuated, developed by Germanier in 1975, known as TY21A. It is the entry-coated capsule, stored refrigerated, given 3 doses on alternate days. You can repeat it after 3 to 5 years of age, and it is recommended after 7 years of age. Chickenpox vaccine, commonly known as varicella vaccine. This was developed by Takahashi in 1971 in Japan. It is live attenuated OK strain, available as lyophilized powder, dissolved in 0.5 ml of diluent, given subcutaneously, single dose, in the age group of 1 to 12 years, 0.5 ml, and after 13 years of age, 2 doses are given 1 month apart. In short, we have seen all these vaccines individually and immunization programs and details of theory in this. But we have to always remember this: before the invention of vaccine, how much catastrophe this has caused. In 1920, 13,000 people are died yearly because of diphtheria before the invention of diphtheria vaccine. In 1940s, 8,000 people are died yearly before the pertussis vaccine was developed. In 1952, polio has paralyzed 21,000 children worldwide. In 1963, 3 million cases of measles were there and 500 deaths were recorded yearly before the vaccine was invented. In 1964 to 1965, 12.5 million cases of rubella was there and 20,000 infants were born with congenital rubella before the invention of vaccine. And lastly, in the 1985, 12,000 meningitis cases was caused by H influenza type B vaccine before the invention of H influenza B vaccine. All this could have been prevented if the vaccine was invented properly at the required time. And now we are facing the challenge and we are waiting for the vaccine for COVID-19. Thank you. In short, we have seen all details about the vaccination. This is very important backbone or a milestone in child's life. Thanks a lot.